Hi, my name is Brechtje and you are watching Estona Tutorials. And if you are watching this video, you are not currently on my subscriber feed. So you can watch a part of this video, but if you want to get the full experience, then please hop on over to Patreon and you can find me at patreon.com/Estona_tutorials. I hope I'll see you there. To make a pendant for a cabochon stone, you will need the following items. A gemstone to start out with. It can be a flat gemstone, like this one, or a rounded one, as long as the back side of the gemstone is flat, and please make sure that you choose a hard gemstone. Some metals to work with. I am using silver, but you can use another metal as well. I have a very thin plate for the bezel that's about 0.6 millimeters thick and a thicker plate for the back of the pendant, and this is about a millimeter thick. Your measuring tools, such as your vernier calipers and your metal dividers, and a scribe tool. Of course, your saw blade and some lubricant. Half rounded pliers. Your soldering equipment. Your file, different types of sanding paper and sanding sticks, a small ball burr, a drill, and some polishing discs for your flex shaft. In case you want to darken your piece, you can use some patina and a brush. I am using Blitz Bites for this. A shellac stick with some protoplast, a hammer, and a bezel punch. And I am using a regular burnisher and a needle burnisher. So for me, this is the absolute best part of making jewelry, working with stones. I am going to show you in this tutorial how you can make a bezel setting. You are going to make a little cup that the stone will fit in exactly, and you are going to fold over the edges of the cup over the stone. And let's say that this is the side of my stone. Then I am going to make a bezel setting that is about this high. So I just need a little bit of extra silver to fold over the stone so that it holds the stone in place. And here you can see that my solder is starting to melt, so I'm guiding the solder with my flame and making sure that the solder flows in between the seam. And remember, solder will flow to the hottest point, so make sure that your flame is right there where you want the solder to flow. And now that the four sides of the bezel are in place, I'm going to tap down the rest, and always make sure that you don't end up with one big piece of silver at one point. Spread out what you are doing. And I'll use my needle burnisher to clean up the inside here. And this is it, and this is what your first stone setting can look like. If you are curious to see how you can make a setting like this for a ring, then check out this tutorial. And I hope you'll have a lot of fun practicing. And just enjoy making beautiful things.